Oh, baby. Oh, yes. We're in. We're in to win. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, I remember this part. This is the demo. It's missing some parts, but... Oh, no. Oh. Let's just say I'm glad I'm sitting down. Maybe I don't need to sit down for this. I thought I did, but I'm just sitting down for the ease of comfort. Oh, my God. I'm just going to take all this in. That's really high up. Oh, I hate that. I love it, but I hate it. Oh, no. Oh, God, now I got the willies. Oh, Jesus. Are you going to go across there? Jesus. I forgot I don't grab your tail, I grab you. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh my God, no. Catch me, Trico. Oh, put me down. Oh, sweet Jesus. Holy fuck, that's scary. Oh, thank you, boy. Oh God. Okay. Oh, that's scary. I mean, it's scary in the regular game. Where do I go? On your back. I'm ready. I shouldn't yell because I'm right in your ears. Are you afraid? Oh, Jesus. Oh, this is so cool. Oh, dude. Do it, Trico. Do it, Trico. Do it. Oh, fuck yeah. Okay, I legit teared up at that part. I know it's stupid. But this means a lot to me. Oh my God. I don't even know how to commentate on this because I'm just in awe. Yeah. Okay, I'm sorry. Hi. Come here. I'll tell you. Oh no, is that it? No! Oh, I was just getting started. Oh, and I'm sad. Oh man.
Whew. Okay, that was marvelous. That was everything I could have hoped it to be. Oh, that was so cool. Because I had an idea in my head before I played it, how everything would look and the scale of it and everything. It was way better than I could have imagined. I legit teared up at that last part, going across the thing. Because just being on his back for the first time, I being able to see all around and see what the boy was able to see in the game. Because when you're playing the game, you want to be that boy. Well, kind of. You don't want to do the treacherous things that he does. But you want to be able to, like, sit on top of Trico and see what it's like to be able to witness the world all around you. And that's just so cool. And that's the thing that VR, I think, does best, is selling the scale of everything. And if it's a game built for VR from the ground up, it's kind of hard to get that sense of scale. Well, obviously, the sense of scale is there, but what I'm trying to say is that having played The Last Guardian normally on the PlayStation, and then seeing everything the way it was and having it in your head of how you think it would have looked if you were there, and then to actually be transported into it and definitely see the scale of everything and how it was to be there, is mind-blowing. And it's a shame that the game is kind of just like point at a thing, press X to go to that thing, and then having limited interactivity around that. I get the limitations. VR is hard to do, especially for a game that's not designed for VR, and then you just cram VR into it. And this is just a demo to try and show off and sell the VR feel. And it was even this was just really, really damn good. And I'm highly impressed with PSVR. Like, I play HTC Vive as my main VR platform all the time. And that's an incredible platform to be able to play VR games. Like, the resolution and the tracking and everything feels very good, and the controllers are very good. But this is damn convincing. If you're out there looking to buy VR stuff, and you're like, oh, I don't know about PSVR because it's a lesser platform and it costs less, and you think that it's not going to be as good, it's very, very good. If you want to get a sense for what it's like, every time I play these VR games, if you want to get a sense for what it's like to play, like, a HTC Vive game, but you can't afford that, this is a very good option. And it definitely sells the sense of it. It's not perfect, it's not the exact same, but it definitely gives you that feel of what it's like to be in the VR games, like the way I play them all the time. So if you're looking for a budget option, this is the way to go. And there's a lot of games coming out of this, and Sony are giving a lot of support to this. Like, with stuff like this is just a demo, but they're making a lot of games for this, and they're really trying to sell it and make it go places. And a lot of the experiences aren't amazing, but a lot of the experiences in my HTC Vive aren't amazing either. Like, they're still just games where you sit down and you interact with the world coming towards you a lot of the time. It's very few and far between when you get something like Super Hot VR and Sprint Vector, those types of things where you have complete and direct interaction with your environment. So don't feel bad if you have one of these and if you're looking at me play HTC Vive games going, oh, that must be so much better. It's not that much different. Some stuff is, but I mean. There's a lot of games out there that are still just gimmicky, and you're still just sitting down and, like, shooting waves of enemies coming at you, so it's not that different. We're still yet to see people fully adopt that sort of stuff. But anyway, back to The Last Guardian, amazing! It's so fucking good! And it's free, it's just a demo right now. I don't know if they plan on doing more with it. I think this is just kind of like a showcase that they were doing, so I think this might be all we ever get with The Last Guardian VR. You would get more, but I don't really know how much more you'd get out of it. I would settle for a whole game of just going around on Trico's back. That would be marvelous. I'm just happy that I get to go back into that world, because I miss that game so much. It's one of my favorite series that I've ever done on the channel, and it was one of those series that everybody on the channel got behind. And that almost never happens. These are like the miracle series that really stick with people. And this is a series that I remember forever. No matter how long I do YouTube, no matter where I go, I always remember what it was like to record that series. Because it had such emotional weight to me. It had such emotional impact to me. And it was a game I was waiting for years and years and years. And we all thought it wasn't going to come out. And then it finally came out. And to some people didn't like it. The controls were a little clunky. The camera was all over the place. And yeah, I agree. But I just had so much emotional investment in it that I looked past those and I was able to enjoy it anyway. And then to think that you're sitting there in a VR experience, just looking at Trico next to you. It's just outrageous. I never ever thought that day would come. I never even thought that was a day that could come. And now to have it here in front of me is just spectacular. absolutely blown away. I wish there was more to it. I wish I could just do more of this type of stuff, but it is what it is. I'm just glad I got to play it all. Right,